What's going on, guys? Thanks for tuning in to this episode of ACM Insider. Today, we're talking with industry expert Sue Woodard, who is the Chief Customer Officer at Total Expert, which for those that don't know, is an industry-leading CRM and marketing automation system. So with that said, Sue, how's it going today? By the way, this is our take two because I forgot to hit the record button earlier. So how's it going today?
Hey, it's going great. It's even better the second time around, Corey.
That's right.
So yeah, thanks for having me.
Absolutely. Thanks for tuning in today. And so one of the things, like I said in the first take that I'll say again now that we actually are rolling, is I want to provide a little bit of context for those that are they're jumping in on this episode. So a couple of key things we're going to be providing context and information around is just providing key insights that can help loan officers better build their personal brand, their business, expand their sphere of influence and reach, particularly online. And then it's also meant to help you as a loan officer better understand the new and evolving technologies, i.e. Total Expert, that are available to you and how you can leverage these new technologies like Total Expert to better connect, engage, and convert your audience at scale. So that being said, take two, Sue, of giving us a little bit of background on how you got started in the industry and then who Total Expert is and the value that Total Expert and you provide to loan officers and, you know, mortgage companies in general. So I'll turn it over to you.
Yeah, you got it. Well, I've been in the mortgage and financial services industry for 30 years now, which I can't believe I'm old enough to be able to say that.
You're still new at it. Still figuring it out.
Tell you what. But, well, we all got started in weird ways, right? Like no little kids are running around on the playground saying, I want to be a loan officer, right? So everybody kind of falls backwards into the mortgage industry somehow. But I was actually working at a credit union. I was doing car loans and consumer finance. And we kept getting robbed. And it was my best friend and roommate at the time was the head teller, robbed at gunpoint. And I was like, okay, this is crazy. I got to find a safer branch to work in. And the only job that was open was a mortgage processor. And I had no idea what a mortgage processor was, but I thought, hey, that sounds safer. So I'm going to go, you know, work at that branch. And the rest is really history. And I fell in love with the mortgage industry just because, you know, I think about the how special it is what we do, you know, because home is where your life happens, right? Yeah. And it's where you laugh and where you cry. And every time people are going through, you know, a home purchase in particular, man, something important in their life is happening, right?
Absolutely.
Somebody's getting married, getting divorced, a baby's being born, somebody's got a new job, you know, like life is happening. And we get to be a part of that and help people make good long-term strategic decisions that can literally impact their financial future and their legacy for life. So it's like, it's just, oh, I love the mortgage industry. So I originated for many, many years, loved originating. And I eventually had the chance to start doing some speaking and really then start to get into the vendors.
No, not you, Sue. You don't.
A little bit. You know, but you know, it's been such a joy to be on the vendor side of the business, partly because, you know, back when I was originating, I mean, I was using, you know, post-it notes and, you know, crazy stuff. ACT was like the hot technology of the day, right? To try to stay in contact with your customers. And, you know, so it's been really exciting to see technology advance like we have at Total Expert. Literally what we do is literally empower, you know, you and your originators to have their brand be consistent, to have the right message at the right time to the right person, to use intelligent automation. I mean, this is the stuff I was dreaming about as an originator 20 years ago. Now it's real. So for me, it's not just, you know, kind of what I do during the day. This truly is a passion and a joy for me because I can see the difference that we make literally in companies, in for loan officers, businesses, and ultimately the consumers that you serve.
Yeah, no, I think that's great. I mean, one of the things that I love about our partnership, which I also distinguish between, you know, you guys aren't to us, aren't just a vendor. We are true partners. You guys treat us great, which is fantastic. But one of the things I love about it is, like you said, you know, we're being able to engage and interact at these huge points in time, often when it's a new chapter in someone's life, where, like you said, whether it's getting married, divorced, having kids, whatever the case is, it's really impactful. And so the way that you're able to engage with those individuals or those families means a lot, right? And so being able to even find them, you know, in times of like right now, there's a lot of refinances that are going on. So even with that, being able to find those opportunities to provide that level of support, I think is such a huge deal that not a lot of people really think about. And you guys, obviously from the CRM and marketing automation side, provide so many different easy ways for people to do that. And that kind of leads me into this next topic. So with more modern advances in technology, the growing need to have social presence and be able to connect with leads and borrowers at the right time, you know, through the right channels, what do you think are the current challenges that most, if not all, loan officers are facing, and what are some possible solutions that you guys are seeing, you know, as you're on the forefront of this new technology aspect?
Yeah, well, you know, it's interesting you bring up challenges, because I always, there's always going to be challenges of some flavor. And if you've been in the industry for any length of time, how many times have we gone through things where people have said, this is it, it's the end of the industry, and, you know, things are going to be over forever. But, you know, I think, I always think, like, there's a great quote that it says something like, the brick walls are there for a reason, and they're there to keep out the people who don't want it as bad as you do, right? So, like, when things are challenging, embrace that, because you know that that's going to be able to keep other people, you know, out who don't want to work as hard, right?
Absolutely.
So, I think, you know, the interesting thing as far as the challenges right now, you know, when you look back to 2008, very interesting, because that particular time in the industry, we were the villains. Now we can be the heroes, right? So we can be the heroes. But I think it's a matter of how are you going to connect with people, right? So, you know, when you think about being the heroes, you think about educating people, you think about that customer experience, you think about who the hero in the story is, and that's got to be your customer. Well, how do you do that, you know, now? So this is all about how do you combine the best of human and technology, right? Yep. And so you think about even what we're doing right now and what we're all doing, we're all zooming into each other's homes, right? And this is the ultimate combination of like human and technology. But when you think about how we're dealing with our customers in that same way, it's how are you making that connection with them, knowing that you can't do it in exactly the same ways. Obviously, video is a huge deal. I think one of the huge things that has happened that's been fantastic is when I go out and talk to loan officers, I used to ask, you know, how many of you are doing video, any kind of video marketing, you know, and it's like, you know, one or two people raise their hands. When you ask why, they're like, well, I'm not sure what to say. And it's like, you know what, that's BS. It's because you don't like what you look like on camera. Right?
Like everybody's self-conscious.
Oh, like, my gosh. Fearful, it's
like,
totally.
But if they don't like me, it's like high school almost.
It's so funny. But, you know, and the reality is, that's literally what your face looks like all day long. You're just 100%. Normally backstage of your face, right? You know, you're just not looking at it. So I think one of the brilliant things that has happened, you know, during this very interesting era that we're living in is that everybody's used to looking at their face on camera now, right? Because everybody's been doing Zoom or WebEx or what have you. And they say there's two kinds of people. There are the people who are looking at themselves while they're doing a Zoom or video call. And liars, right? Like everybody's looking at themselves, right? So now we're all used to seeing ourselves. So now you can make that connection with people. And they say that video marketing, you know, even before all this happened, it's the number one, video is the number one consumed marketing channel. And so I think it's a great way that you can make those connections with people. But it's all about education. I mean, right now I think there's so many people that need so much help. They need so much advice, because even if the person that you're talking to is not themselves, maybe they're okay. Maybe they're, you know, their job is okay. But pretty much everybody out there is about one degree of separation away from somebody who's really struggling, right? Yep. Who's got, you know, whether it be, you know, business or health or, you know, something going on in their lives right now. You know, it's a rough time and people are looking for advice. So I do think the biggest challenge right now, and again, this is what we're trying to do, you know, at Total Expert, is really how do you combine human and technology? Because, you know, technology, sometimes people would look at technology and say like, oh, it's, remember in the days people would be like, oh, it's going to take over the loan officer, right? Oh my gosh, nothing could be further from the truth. In fact, you know, we like to say that technology is not here to replace the loan officer, but the loan officer leveraging technology will replace the one who isn't, right? And so this is a time to like really, really dig in. And we even say, hey, you know, going further than that, it's the companies, the brands like Atlantic Coast that really dig in, that invest and, you know, are pouring into the best tools for their folks. These are the brands that are going to thrive and survive in the future. So I think there are, you know, some of the challenges literally are just figuring out how do you navigate in a new world. I think one of the most important things that companies and loan officers can be doing right now is making sure that you're really reevaluating your customer journey and your customer experience, okay? Because like, you know, we think about that and talk about that a lot here, is like, what is our customer journey? What is our customer experience? Where are the rubs in it? You know, where we maybe have a gap or that we're frustrating somebody?
Absolutely.
And how do we make that better? And so I think, you know, we've spent a lot of time doing that at Total Expert. And I think even if you've done this now as an individual or as a business, you got to redo it because the world is different. So literally, even if you're at home in your dining room, get the post-it notes, map it out, you know, on the wall and say, what does it look like to work with me now? Even if you've done this before, you better do it again, because it's very easy to be perceived as tone deaf right now when, again, there's a lot of, you know, pain and frustration out there. I mean, seriously, even some of your marketing messages, you really have to rethink. Like, is that still on point or, you know, do I need to rethink that? So I think it's, you know, literally one of the biggest things I advise people do right now, map out your entire customer journey. And if you're an originator listening to this, you know, you should be mapping it out for your customers, map it out for your referral partners, you know, map it out even for your internal, you know, I like to call your internal network. That was always a group of people that were really important to me when I was originating, was, you know, the folks in operations, you know, processing, underwriting. How are you staying connected with them? How are you still, you know, appreciating them, you know, in ways that maybe you can't take them to lunch anymore, things like that.
That makes sense.
So think that through. I think that's one of the biggest things people can be doing right now.
No, I think that's so good. And the reality is, at least I know for us, you know, where you're bringing in new technology, you're trying to get user adoption, all those things. Well, with the pandemic and some of the things that are occurring right now, it disrupted everybody's, I don't really need to do this right now because I'm still doing good with how I've always done things. And then it completely just disrupted and shifted everything.
Yep.
Now people are like, oh, okay, what's this Zoom thing all about? What's Slack about? How do I use the CRM? How do I do this?
That's and so right.
It's kind of opened up people's eyes. You know, it's always trying to look for the silver lining in any, you know, not optimal situation, kind of like with what we're in right now. But I think that it's opened up people's eyes to realize the power that they have. You know, I always talk about the difference between growth and scale, and particularly with Total Expert and some of the tools you guys integrate in with, like BombBomb videos and other things like that. Part of the conversation I always have, and to your point with video, is you're able to have a one-on-one conversation almost at scale. So most people are thinking like growth minded, where it's like, okay, well, I'm going to hire one person. Now I can connect with, you know, one other person. Right. So there's like a one-to-one ratio, or like a one to maybe two or three, whereas scale is allowing you to do one to many, you know, and essentially being able to do, like you were talking about with video, where I can jump on and I can create a journey, or I can send out a video, one time broadcast to people with my face on there, and I'm doing the video, and I also have some text in there. Like, those are the things that are connecting with people. And it's, you know, goes fall in line with what your mantra is, as far as, you know, the right time through the right channel, all of those key aspects, right?
Yeah.
So how do you see technology evolving the role of the modern day loan officer? Obviously what you guys are doing right now is constantly pushing people to think outside of the box, but even with where we're at right now, the disruption, people being kind of shifted in their mindsets, which is another huge aspect of it, shifting your mindset in the first place. But how do you see the role of technology evolving that modern day role for the loan officer?
Well, a couple things. And again, it kind of goes back to saying that, you know, technology isn't here to replace, you know, loan officers. It's here to, you know, to really just improve it and make that beautiful marriage between, you know, the human interaction and technology making that possible, right? Where technology should automate all the things it can, but raise up those opportunities. I know you mentioned Sales Boomerang, you know, earlier. What a perfect example, right? Of raising up an opportunity where you come in as a human being and step in to reach out your hand and help, right? So I do think customer experience is a huge thing. You know, customers have so many options, and now they're looking at a lot of things digitally, right? It's not going to be like, oh, I bumped into this guy, you know, at the, you know, wherever. And so it's going to be, people are doing a lot of research online. So it's really thinking about that customer journey and that customer experience. And technology should really be empowering you to optimize that experience, right? To know when those opportunities are, to maximize those touch points. You know, another thing we say a lot here at Total Expert is that, you know, every interaction that you have with a customer is an opportunity to either build trust or erode trust, right?
Oh,
and
good.
So you have to, and you're going to, let's face it, you know, you're human, you're going to have times you're like, oh, darn, you know, I let you down.
Right.
But every single interaction somebody has with you and your brand is an opportunity to build trust or erode trust. And sometimes not being there in the time when somebody's expecting you to be can erode trust.
Yep.
You know, sometimes, like we were talking about earlier, somebody's going through something in their life when they're purchasing a home. And we very often lose the wonder of what we're doing. You know, when you think about the terms we throw around, like approval and money and home, these are huge triggers for a lot of people. This is very stressful. Big money is very stressful. And we kind of are like, this is just what we do, right?
Right.
So it's really important to make sure that you're treating that experience in that way where you're really truly, you know, there for that person when their emotions are probably already jangled based on everything going on in the world right now, right? You know, the second thing I would say is just the efficiency and productivity and consistency. You know, what I always wanted when I was originating is I just want the magic to happen for me. I just wanted, you know, I wish like the letters would just go out and the messages would just go. And, you know, I'd get this little automated message that would just tell me like, hey, you're supposed to call this person on this day. Well, that's actually reality now, right? I mean, that's actually what technology can do. But it does take, you know, you said something interesting earlier about, you know, when you're talking about kind of the engagement and adoption, it does take a bit of investment, right? And I know what you're doing at Atlantic Coast is you're putting, you know, these kind of the best practices in place and letting that magic happen for people. And that's a beautiful thing. I mean, it really is. And I think the amount of that we've seen across our customer base that you gain in efficiency, in consistency, in productivity, you know, the amount of time that people generally spend digging around, looking for things, you know, I don't know, where's that thing, trying to find that phone number, you know, let technology work for you and enable you to literally, you know, when a daily digest comes to you that says, here's the people that are interacting with your marketing. Here's the new leads that came in, you know, from that thing that you did with the realtor. Here's the open house.
Checklist, basically.
It's a checklist, right? Yeah. And so, and it comes to you. You don't have
just
to go
do
look
the
for
checklist.
It. Yes, this was like my wildest dream when I was originating, is having, oh, I wish that thing could be sent to me. Well, now it is, right? And so, I do think it's a time that, you know, it's a time for, you know, the best originators right now are re-examining their businesses, re-examining their customer experience, and engaging. You know, and I know people are always like, oh, you know, I don't have time. You know, it just takes too much. You don't work. You know, if you've got time to watch Tiger King or bake your own bread or whatever people are doing at home right now, you got time, you know? And I think it just, it has such payoffs, you know, it has such payoffs. Investing just a little bit of time, you know, getting it set up, really understanding it, and then just letting it work for you. And I think that, you know, the final thing is really just enabling technology to help you. Sometimes people don't feel like technology and relationship belong in the same sentence.
Yes, it's not an uphill battle all the time.
Yes, but you know, they really do. I mean, let's be honest. How do you know most people's birthdays?
Because
Facebook tells you, right? Yeah. You know, I mean, it's like, I mean, honestly, technology enables us. It's in your calendar and Outlook. It pops up something that to tell you that. So you're like, oh, I got to, you know, remember to so-and-so. Or Facebook tells you, you know, LinkedIn now has it. I mean, it's technology can be a very powerful part of very real relationships. And especially when people are looking for, you know, people are afraid right now. People are unsure right now. They're looking for advice and answers. You know, to be able to be there and be that trusted advisor and simply do what you say you're going to do. You know, provide that consistency. When they start working with you, the worst thing to have happen is that, you know, maybe I see this happen a lot where you know the transactions are processed, you know it's all set. That customer's freaking out, you know, because they don't know it's all set. So it's putting those pieces in place where you know you need to reach out your hand and say, everything's okay, I got you, right? And so I think it's, again, that customer experience, you know, the productivity and efficiency that can be gained, but it's really about the trust that you can build during a time like this. You know, we can be here and be the heroes this time instead of the villains, yep. Like the last crisis. You know, so be the hero, be there for your customers, educate them, and just don't lose sight of the fact that regardless of if it's a purchase or refinance, this is a stressful time. It's a stressful time for people. Emotions are heightened. And you can really be there at a meaningful time and show up for your customers.
Yeah, I love that. And I think that's such an important part to highlight of what you're talking about, where if you're truly putting your customers first and you're thinking about that engagement piece, to your point of, like you said, they're going through this process. This is something they do maybe a few times their entire life, right?
Right.
Whereas like we're thinking, you know, you're doing this a couple of times a day or a week. And so for you, it's almost like you've been desensitized to that process, to that stress.
Yep.
Yes, loan officers have a certain level of stress, but it's in other areas, you know, dealing with the processors, closers, et cetera, et cetera. But I think putting yourself in that person's shoes and realizing that technology can actually play a crucial role in your ability to better engage with them and walk them throughout that process. Because at the end of the day, if you're a great loan officer, is it more selfish for you to only help a small few people or to help as many people as possible with the exceptional service that you provide?
That's
right. For me, that's one of the things I love, you know, with our loan officers that do an amazing job. It's like, this is an amazing tool to allow you to do this at scale and be there at the right time, at the right moment to ease their stress. Because even if you're getting, say, a message that's letting you know the status of what your loan is, that oftentimes, just that simple piece of communication removes that unnecessary stress of like, oh, okay. All right. Yeah. I know Sue's working on it. I know she's looking at my file. I know that it's getting pushed through. Right. So having those tools and systems in place it doesn't, to your point, I've heard that argument too, where I don't want it to feel like it's not personable anymore. And I'm like, actually, this is going to make it feel like it's more personable. That's because right. you don't have to put as much time and energy necessarily into each interaction, because you're doing it in a smart way that's also not just letting you interact with them at the right moment in time, but it's also letting you know when to personally engage with them, because you need to have that level of engagement. But not everything requires, you know, a personalized text messages or email or phone call.
That's right.
So let's automate that stuff, and then we'll let you know as the loan officer when the right time is for you to kind of step in with that personal, that level of engagement. Yeah. So I think that's such a great, yeah, I think you made some great points there. And sort of a two-part follow-up question for that. What do you think it means to be a modern day loan officer and a modern day mortgage company? You know, because those are really two different things, because you can have a modern day loan officer that's in a not as modern company, right? Because a lot of people have sort of these disparate systems, where it's like you may have one high producing loan officer that has their own set of systems, yep, their own level of technology. That's also one of the things I love in Atlantic Coast, is for the most part, we have all these different systems that are literally paid for. It's just a matter of just using them or asking for help from the, you know, from the marketing team or the IT team of like, hey, can I get some support? Can I go through training? Yeah, absolutely. No problem. But not every company has that. So maybe talk to us a little bit about what does that mean to be a modern day loan officer, just holistically speaking, and then also how that dovetails into what it means to be a modern day mortgage company. Because you see it all, I know.
Yeah, yeah. Well, and I'll tell you, I mean, it's interesting because I think the answers are the same. And it's the same, you know, when I think about being a modern day mortgage technology company, right? Like, right, what does this look like right now? And I'd say there's three things, some of them that we've touched on already, but I'll just say three things. The first thing is really digging into that customer experience and that customer journey. It is something that I'm thankful that finally the industry is paying more attention to, because I think it used to be almost like, I mean, my gosh, like a rite of passage, like, you know, you have to fill out 80,000 forms. And, you know, like back in my day, we climbed 80 miles uphill both ways to take a loan application, right? Like
now you got the elevator.
Right. So I know. So you have to think about, like, really think about that customer experience and you know, do some secret shopping on yourself. You know, I mean, like have somebody, yeah, you know, I mean, it's so important to really look at it with very fresh eyes. You know, somebody new coming into your business, ask them, what do you see? What strikes you as weird? What strikes you as great? Is there something that you feel like is missing? You know, right, ask if you've got somebody that went through the process that's willing to be real honest with you, you know, ask them where could I have done better? You know, like really dig for those insights. And again, I would tell you, we learned so much just literally, like I said, old school, mapping it out on a wall. We took an entire wall in our office before COVID happened and mapped out our entire customer journey. And Corey, we found all kinds of gaps in there where we said, yep, we could do better, right? We can do better here, here, and here. And you have to do it again now, right? So I think because people have so much, so many options right now, it's really thinking about what are they feeling right now, right? Like what's, yep, you know, what is their pain at this thing? Or what is their emotion at this? Is it fear? Is it uncertainty? Is it, you know, what is it? And really feel that and figure out how do you address that for each of those personas, right? And for you as a company, you get different personas. What does it look like to be, you know, a loan officer that's been here a long time? What does it look like to onboard, you know, here at our company? What does it look like when you're in operations versus what is it, you know, an originator? What is, I mean, right, really just breaking down each of the personas that you're serving as a company and saying, how do we do better? Where are the gaps in the experience and how do we level up? And you guys do such a great job. I mean, seriously, you said it so well a minute ago. It's one of the things that is just brilliant about Atlantic Coast is that you do provide just the best of the best in terms of all of the options, but you let people kind of pick their own recipe, you know, and make, yeah, it their own.
Which is sometimes good, sometimes it's not, you know, sometimes, right, let's add a little bit more seasoning into that. There's a few more things we could add to make this.
Yes, good. Yes, exactly. Exactly. But I do think, like I said, that's the first thing is really just paying a lot of attention, right, you know, wherever you're at. If you're a loan officer, mortgage company, mortgage technology company, you got to pay attention to that. It's critically important. And I think the modern mortgage company, the modern loan officer is all about looking ahead and innovation, you know, as well, because, you know, things feel like they're moving so fast, but things are never going to move slower than they are right now, right? It's only going to go faster and faster and faster and faster. And so I think that's one of the reasons, you know, people partner with Total Expert is not that we necessarily have all the answers right now, but you're deciding who you're going to hook your wagon to and really saying, right, hey, who's innovating into the future and who's going to be looking at all the things we can. It's why people come to work at Atlantic Coast, because they know they're counting on you to be looking ahead for them, right? They're doing their thing every single day. They're counting on your leadership to be looking ahead. And so, you know, how do you transform data into actionable insights? We were talking about that a little bit. You know, how do you turn all the data that we have? People love to talk about
data. Data is a popular word right now, but it's like, well, how do you turn that into usable information?
That's exactly right. And some of that, honestly, we're even looking at it at just, you know, let's, you start with one bite of the elephant, right? You know,
100%.
Because people go nuts talking about this. I hear people at, you know, at conferences, you know, digital and otherwise, all about data, but it's the same companies that can't even manage to send out like a birthday note to somebody on their birthday. It's like, come on, you know, like, let's start, stop talking about like crazy stuff and let's just start taking bites out of this, right? And so that's one of the things that we're looking forward to is kind of saying, hey, how do we start giving more, you know, actionable insights, you know, more intelligence to the data that's there and teeing up those opportunities, not making go look for them, but teeing them up so you can grab them as a human and go take advantage of those, right? That I think is a critical thing. Again, tech company, mortgage company, loan officer, is how are you innovating? Whatever that looks like for you. I think for a loan officer, you got to be, gosh, man, just investing in yourself. My origination business changed once I really realized there's all these resources out there. There's speakers and there's, you know, things and there's classes and courses and tools. Like when I started really investing time, and you know what, I was an originator, I was a single mom originating. I was like, you know, super busy. I time blocked everything out, but I had a time block of time where I would invest in my business, because otherwise you get so busy working in your business, you never work on it, right? And so I think whatever that looks like, if it's Total Expert, Sales Boomerang, BombBomb, some of the other amazing tools that ACM's given you, or it's just classes, courses, you know, personal development, professional development, block out time and go do that. It's just critically important to constantly be looking forward and innovating, you know, for yourself. And Corey, I know you guys do this, you know, we do this at Total Expert. I love when we come together. You were one of our featured speakers at one of our events like that, you know, where, but that was yours was a huge session where people loved to hear those insights. And that's what it's about, is how are we constantly making ourselves better and innovating into the future. You know, the final thing I would say in terms of just being a modern day loan officer, modern day mortgage company or tech company, is it's about trust. You know, I said a minute ago, I'll say it again. Every interaction that somebody has with you and your brand, you can either build trust or you erode trust, you know, in every interaction. Right. And
that's
so
it's more really, part of any relationship, right?
Yes. Yes. It's so true. And so it's really, I think, just being mindful of that we have such an opportunity, especially right now as mortgage companies, as loan officers, particularly to really regain trust, to be the heroes, to be there with advice and information and guidance and that personal touch, remembering that people are, I think people were freaked out a year ago about buying a house. They're really freaked out, you know, right now, like really being there and feeling them and being that guide for them. I just trust in our world right now, Corey, a little bit as we were talking about before, it is at an all-time low. It's an all-time low. And so I know trust feels like it's something kind of soft, but I think it's one of the most critical things to really be very thoughtful about in terms of how are you building that trust? How are you showing up? Asking yourself when you know, are off the line with somebody, did I just build trust with them or did I erode trust?
Right.
And what experience are they having? So I don't know. Those are the big things that stand out to me.
No, I love that. I think the trust is so crucial, obviously with any relationship, whether you're talking about your internal teams, like with my team, or you're talking about your relationship, you know, in your personal life or anything else. So I think filtering everything through that lens of literally asking yourself that question, am I building trust or am I eroding trust? And if the answer is I'm eroding trust, then I need to pivot and figure out how I can turn that thing around so that I'm always building trust with whoever that individual is. The other couple of things that you touched on that I think are great is you talked about, you know, opportunity gaps, basically, or just gaps in general. That's one of the things, you know, we're always trying to do here. That's one of the things I'm always trying to do with my team. I'm like, let's go hunting for the gaps. You know, we just had a meeting last week and found a few gaps in some of our processes that we got shored up. And it's like, that's sort of a rinse and repeat process that you don't really see people doing. It's like, oh, well, found them all. And it's like, no, this is an ongoing thing. If you want to continue to refine, to get better, find new opportunities. And I think right now, yeah, I've been saying this for a while, but I feel like, and it's starting the gap is starting to narrow in terms of opportunities, because I think that, to your point, you know, the companies that are moving first, particularly in the technology space, and the loan officers that are adapting first, are the ones that are going to end up being the winners at the end of the day.
That's right. Because
by the time other people or other companies or other loan officers realize, like, oh, I need to learn this system. Well, it's too late because Joe down the road has already mastered it. Why would someone want to go to you who's figuring it out when he already has this aspect of it mastered? And not only does he have it mastered, but because he has it mastered, it's building and growing those relationships he already has, which, as we know, last I checked, you know more than just yourself. So what are you going to do? Word of mouth. Tell somebody else, hey, my experience with Joe is amazing. You need to go check him out. So it's one of those things where I'm always encouraging our loan officers, and everything of, hey, you don't have to adopt everything now, but have an adaptive mindset where you're constantly adapting. Another thing I always say is, if you're not growing, then you're dying. And it's the same thing with what you said a second ago. The more you learn, the more you earn. That's a famous quote that people like to use a lot too. And it's like putting those things hand in hand of like, all right, I'm going to have an adaptive mindset, whether you're talking about from the upper echelon of the corporate sense or with the loan officer of, I'm going to continue learning. I'm going to continue growing. I think the suggestion that you made of blocking out time is brilliant, because how many times do we say, I'm going to do this? And if you don't make time for it, or you don't have it blocked out.
It's critical. Yeah. It's just, I'm even looking at like your books that are behind you, and you've got some of my favorites back there. But I think, literally, if you're listening to this and you just even want to say, just 6 months from now, what do I want things to look like? You know what? Grab 6 books. You can look behind Corey and see some great options back there, but just grab 6 yep. books, put them on your table, and literally just read 1 book a month. Block 4 hours in a month to say, this is going to be the time I'm going to like dig in. I'm going to learn. I'm going to invest. I'm going to check out all the tools that Atlantic Coast has for me, or I'm going to go out into the industry and find something. I'm going to sign up for a course or class or a session, just block that time out and dig in, because if you don't, it just will never happen. It's like anything else, right? It's the way human nature is, right? Yeah.
If you stop working out, you're going to lose muscle. It's the same thing with everything. And so I think that's such a huge point you made of one, always going hunting. I call it hunting for gaps. You're always going hunting for those gaps, the chink that's in your armor, so to speak. You're shoring those things up. You always have that mindset of, I'm going to constantly learn. I think it's when you get to that point where you're like, I know everything. I'm an expert. And it's like the most expert of experts never have that mindset, because that's they continually right. are trying to grow and learn new things. So with that being said, what do you think are the biggest challenges, that you see? Because obviously with you, you're going to a lot of different companies, you're engaging in different areas of the country, with different range of loan officers that have different production volumes. What are the biggest challenges you see that the mortgage industry and loan officers are facing right now? And how do you think that we navigate those challenges to come out on the other side, both stronger and better?
Well, and I think we touched on this a little bit earlier, kind of talking about some of those challenges, but I think it's about figuring out how do you reinvent yourself, right now, because it's, and again, whether it's looking at that, that customer experience, whether it's, really digging in and investing, I think, the challenges are that it's harder to do some of these things than it was before. It's kind of to your point. I can't go visit customers like I'm used to doing. I would have been in your office already by now, right? But we can't do that. So I think that the challenge, as I said, can also become the greatest opportunity, because, I mentioned before about how, brick walls, you decide you're going to go through them. Other people won't. I told my daughter for years, every time that we would go to, a restaurant, get rude service or something like that, I said, Be so thankful, because this is the way that most people operate, that just enough is good enough, right? And as long as you can do better than that, you're gonna be head and shoulders above people. I mean, it's even things like just returning phone calls. I mean, it's so hard right now to get people to just return a phone call. It's like, it's crazy, but you think about how low the bar is.
Right.
And so right now, I think, although it is challenging and you do have to challenge yourself to look at things in different ways, what an amazing opportunity. And, and I'll tell you just a quick story. My daughter made me think about her. She actually, right before all of this, the COVID shutdown happened, she just graduated from college a year ago. She got a new job within her company and realized about mid-March, right when everything started shutting down and the, you know, world started ending as far as we could tell.
Yep.
She realized she was way over her head, like way over her head, right? She had the position she's in, the person who had it before her had a master's degree and 7 years experience, and she's a fresh college grad, right? So she was freaking out, but also realized she couldn't quit her job, right? Because all of a sudden we're at a, you know, whatever, 13% unemployment rate. And it's like, you know, it's not that easy for fresh college grads to just go out and get a job like it might've been a year or two ago, right? So I told her a couple of things and I said, you know, first of all, you got to remember, yes, this is a challenge, but you can do hard things. And sometimes I think we need to remember that as well. And again, we talked about it earlier. I don't know if you've been in this business any length of time, how many times, again, people have said like, it's the end of the world. We're never going to make it through this. I can name, you know, 8 different times. This is, you know, something
like a recurring theme at this point.
It is, right? It's like, but we got to remember, we can do hard things. We've been through hard things before. We're going to get through hard things again. You know, but I also told her, make a good story out of this. And this is an era in time that I told her, babe, you know, she's 22. I was like, dude, your kids and your grandkids are going to be asking you about this crazy time. You know, this crazy time. Make a good story. Don't make your story that you like freaked out, quit your job, baked bread and binge watched, you know, whatever. Like that can't be your story, right? Like make a story where you said, oh my gosh, I was in this position. I was over my head, but I decided I would dig deep and it became like a cornerstone in, you know, my character and how my professional life is that I came through this time. Make a great story. So I think about for people listening, what's going to be your story of this time? Is this the time where you decide to really dig in and you start saying, instead of just keeping that stack of books sitting there, I'm going to read them. Instead of just thinking, yeah, someday I need to do X and invest in my business, dig in and do it. Instead of saying, yeah, at some point I got to get into total expert in sales boomerang bomb. Like actually do it, block time out and actually do it, because this can be, you look back at this as a turning point in your life, right? Make a great story that you want to tell people about. And you know what? And realistically, Corey, this too shall pass as it always does.
100%. Man, you are preaching right. I need a hanky right now because you're preaching right now, Sue. Yeah. No, I think that's so spot on. You know, what's the story? What's the legacy that you want to leave? And that's such a challenging thing. Like you said, you know, do you want it to be where I'm complacent, or do you want it to be where I come through this better, stronger than I was before? I saw something the other day, I'm probably going to butcher this, but it was just like, you know, if you come through this the same as when you went into it, then time was never the issue. Cause that's the excuse we always use. I don't have time.
It's like, that's right.
We've never had more time on our hands to do anything. Yeah. And that's something that is always kind of like challenging me too, of like, you know, when I start feeling lazy and I don't feel like doing something, I'm like, well, I can't really use that as an excuse now. It's time that's to right. just kind of, you know, get off of your ass, for lack of better words, and just start doing things. You know, the first step is always the hardest. Once you get that first step, it's like going to the gym. You can just make it inside the gym. That's half of the battle, if not more, is already over, you know? Yeah. So,
well, and I'd also encourage people right now. One of the other things I did even before all this happened, but certainly now that it has, is get an accountability partner. Tell somebody else, I'm going to read the book, Rehumanize Your Business, this month. I'm going to read it and I'm going to tell you about it, right? Because once you've said that out loud to somebody, I mean, you know, there's all kinds of interesting science about, you know, goal setting. You know, when you write it down, when you speak it out loud, you know, when you see it, you know, there's all kinds of things like that. But honestly, you know, just telling somebody else that you're going to do it and grabbing an accountability partner, whether it is working out, whether it's digging into your business, grab somebody else in your company and learn something with them. Say, hey, let's block out together X amount of time. Let's dig into these things. Let's ask for our help from our folks at ACM to help us figure out how to use X and, you know, how to do Y, and like grab somebody and do it, you know, make a plan. And I guarantee you got an opportunity right now. This isn't over yet, right? You've got an opportunity. Even if you're saying, man, I should have done this and that over the last few months, it's all right. You know, today's a new day. Let's go forward. You can actually right now make a difference. Like you'll have a different, could have a different world. And, you know, 90 days, 6 months from now, by digging into some of these things and making that choice.
There's no better time than the present.
Right on.
Right. So the best, what do they say? The best time to plant a tree was 20 years ago. The second best time is right now. So
I think they got a fortune cookie the other day. Yeah.
Yeah, I like that. I love that. So the last question I have for you, I know we've been talking about the customer journey a lot, and no one knows, I feel like, or understands, you know, that better than you, that aspect of it, the customer journey. What does that mean? What's the impact? all of that. So how do you see the customer borrower journey evolving, and how can we best engage, you know, that those audiences from an awareness or attention, interest, decision, and advocacy standpoint?
Well, I think, you know, customers have more choices than they ever have had before, right? So your experience has got to be up to par, or they're going to go with a competitor, right? Just almost by, like, by default. And one bad experience could be enough to turn somebody away. Right. And I think about right now, you know, it's interesting. Somebody, one of my coworkers here, Total Expert, actually recently went through buying a house. And he said, I can't imagine that people could ever say that a loan officer wouldn't be necessary, because he said, there's no possible way I could have figured out all the options, how to do it non-contingent, you know, all these different things. He said, there's no way that I could possibly, you know, possibly have done that without a loan officer, right? So I think in terms of how it's evolving, I think the standards are getting higher, but I think the appreciation for somebody who's going to, you know, be there and grab your hand is even greater. You know, the millennials are an interesting group. You might be one. Are you a millennial, Corey?
No, not to date myself, but I was born in 82. So
okay,
I think millennials are technically 84 and on.
Okay. Yes. But you think about the millennials, and they've kind of been like, you know, triple hit, right? Because they, right, you know, have been hit, you know, I mean, you go all the way back to like, you know, 9/11 and, you know, all the things that happened after that, 2008, now they're getting socked again. Right. And they said that it's impacted like 3/4 of millennials in some way. And the vast majority of them are reaching out for help. Right. And so the need is there. The expectation is high because people need that advisor right now. But again, that's how I see it evolving, is that really stepping into that gap and being there with that advice, with that help, with that empathy, building trust, you know, remembering that, you know, and I think it's even just learning how do you put yourself in their shoes? How do you develop that empathy and never losing again that wonder of what this person is going through at this time? You know, again, the terms we throw around about, you know, money, approval, and house. I mean, it's just like, this is a huge deal. So to me, it's all about, you know, it's all about education. It's education and empathy, building that trust. I mean, that to me is what it's about.
Yeah, no, I love that. I mean, that's one of the things I talk about is edutainment with everybody, particularly when it comes like social and things like that. But I think you can do that even in your, you know, your user journeys through things like Total Expert, where it's, you're allowing your personality to come through in a way that truly represents who you are. And because a lot of times what I see is people kind of try and think, okay, I want to appeal to as many people as possible. So what that means is I need to be as plain as possible. I don't want to be like, show like who I am. Let me be generic. And it's like, no, a lot of the people that I see, you know, within Atlantic Coast, particularly that are leveraging social, we're doing fantastic. They're getting business from social. And that's why, one, they're seeing, you know, people are seeing their expertise, but they're also seeing their personality, like, wow, this person, if I have to go through this process, there's nobody I would want to go through this process with other than this person. Like, so I think that's another key part of it too.
It's, yes, authenticity.
Yeah. I love what you talked about with the empathy of being able to put yourself in the other person's shoes, which is difficult to do when you're doing it day in and day out. But I think that's so important. And then allowing yourself to also be who you are, and not feel like you have to kind of, all right, I need to come in my suit and tie, and I have to do, I think, and maybe you could even touch on this a little bit.
Yeah.
I think the notion of what a loan officer is nowadays is vastly different than what it was before. And really, to me, a lot of that is like what I'm alluding to right now, of allowing your personality to come through, to where it's okay to wear a t-shirt. It's okay to kind of dress down, so to speak, when really at the end of the day, it's just you being a human, right? That doesn't mean that you're not being professional. You don't want to dress like a slob, obviously. But I think allowing your own sense of personality to shine through is part of one of the things that can be that competitive advantage that allows you to get more business. Because if you actually look at like you, right? One of the reasons I love connecting with you is not because you're the chief customer officer of Total Expert. It's because you're Sue first. And like, I always have such a great time with you, right? When anytime I leave our conversations, I'm like, man, I feel like I learned something new. I leave feeling better about myself, all those things, right? Yes. And then secondly, you're the chief customer officer of Total Expert, right? And I think people kind of get those things mixed up and forget to like just be themselves.
Yes. You know, I'll tell you something. People do business with people, They don't do business with companies, right? People do business with people. They don't do business with companies. People don't go out and say, you know, I'm just looking for anyone at Atlantic Coast, you know, to work with. I don't care who it is. That, I mean, let's face it, the best brand, that they don't have that happen. People connect with Corey. They connect with John. They connect with Sally. You know, I mean, that's the way that it works, is that people make that connection. And I think, again, you know, you're so right on when you even think about, you know, doing video. There's so much opportunity now. We're inviting each other into each other's homes. I mean, I feel like we've been more distant from each other, but yet we're closer, because I have now seen every employee of mine. I've now seen all their kids, their pets. I know, right. You know, some of what their pajamas look like. You know, I know what their houses are like. I mean, we're so much closer in so many ways. Yeah. And you have a deeper level of intimacy there. And so absolutely what you're saying is right. You know, and you can still do that at scale, right? You can still do it at scale. Like you talk about creating a BombBomb video. You don't have to say, hey, Bob, I wanted to let you know. I mean, you can do that, but you can also just say, hey, just wanted to let you know your appraisal is back. If you've got any questions on it, definitely give me a call. But I know this is an exciting time. You know, it doesn't have to be, you know, it could be something generic that you can use that same one for every single person at that touch point, right? Yep. But let your personality be there. You know, I mean, you know, you do the same thing on LinkedIn, and, you know, I see the things you do, but people feel like they know you, right? And again, I think about this beautiful moment where we're having, it's digital eye contact. Interesting theory out there about digital eye contact feels almost the same as actual eye contact, because we're literally, I'm staring at like a monitor, but you and I are having this great connection, right? And people can have that same connection. And just, yes, you're exactly right. Don't feel like you've got to say it perfect. Don't do it perfect. Do bring in your cat. If you mess up your words, just say, oh my gosh, you know, keep going. Like that's what makes people love you, because they realize, man, you know what? He's just like me. You know?
Yeah, you're humanizing yourself. And totally. I think that goes back to another thing I say a lot is, you know, executing on 80% good enough is better than waiting for 100% perfect, because oftentimes 100% perfect, you'll never get there. Right. Whatever was 100% perfect yesterday is certainly not going to be 100% perfect today. So it's better to just get started and get going than to sit there and be complacent. I don't know how many conversations I've had with people where they're like, man, it took me an hour to do this, like, you know, 30-second video because it kept messing up. And I was like, just relax. Yeah. It's okay. I'm like, have you watched any of my videos? I say, I do this. Like, I'm not perfect. I don't look perfect. But at the end of the day, what's more important? Is it getting the content out there for people seeing who you actually are? Or is it for you to come off with this false perception of who you want people to think that you are, but you're not?
The more perfect it is, the less interesting it's going to be.
100%. And you're setting false expectations that you can never live up to, which I think is equally important, you know? So with that being said, you know, I know we kind of run out of time today. So I want to close with just asking you, you know, are there any final thoughts or anything, you know, any final thoughts you may have or anything that you want to kind of share or plug at the end of this before we go ahead and wrap up?
No, you know, I mean, we're so proud to have Atlantic Coast as part of the Total Expert family. And I really am grateful to have this chance to be on the ACM Insider. But no, I guess, you know, my final message would really just be, and we've touched on it throughout, is use this time to up your game. You know, don't let this go to waste. Make a great story that you'll be proud to tell, and whatever that looks like for you, you know, but time block some time out, grab that, you know, that stack of books and actually, you know, get an accountability partner and do it, because you're going to be, there's no way that if you do just those simple things, 4 hours a month, one book a month, grab an accountability partner, you're going to be better off 6 months from now than you are right now. Right. And so just invest that time, use this time, you know, dig in. And like I said, this is a weird time for all of us, but this can be a game changing time.
I love it. Final words of wisdom from Miss Sue Woodard. Sue, as always, thank you for taking the time to hang out with us. Love you guys. Can't say how much, you know, how grateful we are and how much we're appreciative of you guys, you know, for partnering with us. Thanks for everybody else for tuning in to this week's ACM Insider with Sue. We hope you enjoyed the show. We wish everyone watching or listening a great rest of the day or evening, whichever is applicable to you, and we'll catch you next time. Sue, thanks for tuning in. We'll see you later.
Bye, everybody. Bye, Corey.
Hey, really quick before you go, if you enjoy this content, make sure to follow us here on social, and don't forget to like and share this content. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll catch you in the next episode.